Leia here from leiafirstsight.com, and in this video I will show you how to name alcohols. An alcohol is a molecule that has an OH as its functional group. This is typically shown as ROH, where R means the rest of the molecule and OH is your alcohol functional group. Since alcohol is a high priority functional group, you will add the letters OL as a suffix to your molecule. Starting with this example, we highlight the parent chain and number so that the OH gets the lowest possible number. In this case, we have 5 carbons giving me a first name of pent. We have only single bonds giving me a last name of ane. Since the alcohol occurs on carbon 2, we add the prefix 2-ol. When putting the name together, you can bring the 2 to the front of the name, and that means ol will directly follow ane, and so you drop the e. This gives me a final name of 2-pentanol, where it's A-N instead of A-N-E-O-L. When you have a substituent on your alcohol, you still follow the same rules where your substituent becomes the prefix and the alcohol is your suffix. You may recognize this molecule as having the common name tert-butyl alcohol, but let's see how to name it using the IUPAC rules. We'll start by identifying and highlighting our longest carbon chain. In this case, it's 3 carbons, and numbering so that alcohol gets the lowest number. We have the option of numbering both from the right and the left, each giving oxygen a number 2, so I'll start numbering from the left. Having 3 carbons in my parent chain gives me a first name of prop. Having only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. Since the alcohol is on carbon 2, I have a suffix of 2-ol. And since the methyl is also on carbon 2, I get a prefix of 2-methyl. Putting the name together, remember that the prefix goes first, then the first name, then the last name, then the suffix. Remember to drop the E from ane for a final name of 2-methyl-2-propanol. The rules for naming a cyclic alcohol are just like straight chain alcohols, where you start by identifying the parent chain, in this case a total of 5 carbons, for a first name of pent. Given that the molecule is a ring, I add the prefix cyclo. Only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. Since alcohol is the only group on the molecule, I give it a number 1 and then choose to go clockwise or counterclockwise for a total of 5. The alcohol would give me a suffix of 1-ol. However, since it's the only group on the molecule, the number 1 is understood and does not have to be included. This gives me a final name of cyclopentanol. A diol is a compound that has 2 OH groups on the same molecule, and we'll use this as an example. My parent chain has a total of 6 carbons in a ring. That gives me a first name of hex and a prefix of cyclo. Only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. Since this is a symmetrical molecule, I can choose to number from either direction as long as one OH group gets number 1 and the second one gets number 2. I will write 1, 2 to show which carbons the OH groups show up on, and then I will put di in front of the OL to show that I have 2 alcohols. Putting the name together, I get 1,2-cyclohexane diol. Notice that I did not drop my E in this case, given that I have the consonant D in between 2 vowels. Let's try an example with the pi bond. Identifying my parent chain, I see that I have a total of 5 carbons. If I number from the right, I give my pi bond a number 2. If I number from the left, I give the alcohol a 2. Since the alcohol is higher priority than the pi bond, I number from the right for a total of 5 carbons giving me a first name of pent. Having a pi bond on carbon 3 gives me a last name of 3-ene. Having an OH on carbon 2 gives me a suffix of 2-ol. Putting the name together, I get 3-pentene-2-ol. Notice again that I did not drop the E, and that's because I have the number 2 separating the 2 vowels. Let's try something tricky for the final problem. In this case, I have 2 rings fused together, so I have to go back to the rules of naming bicyclic compounds. I start numbering from the bridgehead closest to the OH group, since that's my highest priority, giving it a number 1, and then follow my way around the ring that has the OH, continuing around the ring that has the bromine, and then jumping to the bridge carbon that has nothing on it. Having 7 carbons in my parent chain gives me a first name of hept. Having only single bonds gives me a last name of ane. Since I have two fused rings, I have to precede with the word bicyclo, and then I have to include how many carbons are unique to each ring in the brackets. I have two carbons unique to the ring portion with the OH, giving me two. I have two unique carbons to the portion with the BR, giving me .2, and one carbon on the bridge giving me .1. Bromine is my prefix, which gives me 5-bromo, and OH is my suffix, giving me 2-ol. Putting the name together, we start with a prefix, then we have the name, and finally we have the suffix. Putting the entire name together, I get 5-bromo bicyclo 2-2-1 heptane 2-ol. When you have a name this complicated, it helps to use your puzzle pieces as a checklist to ensure you didn't miss anything. I have my prefix 5-bromo. I have the start to my bicyclic compound. I have my first name and last name. And finally, I have my suffix.
Are you struggling with organic chemistry? Are you looking for information to guide you through the course and help you succeed? If so, download my ebook, 10 Secrets to Acing Organic Chemistry, using the link below, or visit leahforsythe.com/orgosecrets. That's O-R-G-O secrets. For information regarding online tutoring, visit leahforsythe.com/orgotutor. That's O-R-G-O tutor. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and even share it with a friend or two. If you have any questions regarding this video, leave a comment below or contact me through my Facebook page at facebook.com/leahforsythe. There will be many related videos posted over the course of the semester, so go ahead and click the subscribe button to ensure that you don't miss out.